something cold-hearted. Somebody just hit him and just left him there like a bag of trash in the middle of the road.
A KCRA3 exclusive tonight, an emotional plea for answers after a grandfather was killed in a hit and run. And tonight, new surveillance video in the case showing the victim buying milk just moments before that deadly collision. His widow is talking to KCRA3 in hopes that someone watching right now has the clues needed to crack this unsolved hit and run mystery.
KCRA3's Mike DeSalle spoke exclusively with her this afternoon. He's actually at the scene of the crash where that widow is hoping someone will come forward. Mike?
Yeah, we're standing live on Fulton Avenue just north of Hurley, and it was right here about 12 steps off the sidewalk in the number one lane where investigators say they found that grandfather's body after being hit by a car. And now tonight, from across the street, we are seeing video of that grandfather in the moments before that crash.
And I'm waiting for him to say, "Babe, I'm home." And he just never did.
This is the surveillance video investigators say shows 60-year-old Philip Jensen buying milk just minutes before his death. And this is his widow.
We were a team, you know. We were an inseparable team. And I never expected anything like this to ever take us away. We always thought we had more time.
Debbie Jensen is speaking out for the first time since her husband was killed by what the CHP says had to be a hit-and-run driver last Thursday night.
And by the time I got to the hospital, it was too late. I went in and held him, but I didn't get a chance for him to hear me say goodbye.
Jensen is speaking out in hopes that whoever knows who that driver was or possibly even saw what happened here will come forward with that information.
I can't rest. My family can't rest. And I know Philip's not resting in peace knowing that you're still out there.
As for whoever did this to a grandpa just going to buy milk, his widow has this message.
I don't know if you believe in karma, but it's going to haunt you for the rest of your life. You know, you had to have known what you'd done. I mean, there's no way you could hit a human being and not know.
And back here live tonight at 8:30, there will be a community vigil held just north of this spot at the intersection of Fulton and Whitcup. Meanwhile, the widow told me that she's trying to keep this story out in the public in hopes that someone will come forward. She says even the person who did this, if they're watching right now, she says she's not harboring any anger. She says come forward, say it was an accident, but give her some closure. After all, her husband would have celebrated his 12th wedding anniversary just a few days from now. Galston,
well, Mike, any description right now of the car or the person who hit Mr. Jensen?
No, and that's what makes this case so very different. Aside from the surveillance video that they got from a store right across the street here, the CHP says they really have no clues after that grandfather bought the milk and started to walk home. They say typically in a hit and run, there'll be some broken pieces of the car, maybe a headlight or part of the fender or bumper. But in this case, they say nothing, no traces were left behind. And that is why they're hoping someone will come forward, or whoever did this, their conscience will spark them to come forward. Live along Fulton Avenue, I'm Mike DeSalle, KCRA 3 reports.
Let's hope somebody says something. Mike, thanks.